Eric absolutely loved his friends and was a brother who would show up and be present during the worst times in your life. Eric has been part of my life for over 30 years. During these years, please understand that we fought, we laughed, we cried, and we fought some more. But that was Eric. And if you were his true friend, I know that you experienced these emotions and that you have at least 5 numbers in your phone for Eric. Is that true? I have about 15. Eric number 1, Eric 2022, Eric 2023, Eric 5. Am I the only one? Eric was confident in his craft, but he was sweet and kind, and he lived the way he wanted to live. It would not be odd to see him at a council, church convention, or a church service while everyone else is in their finest suits and wearing their biggest hats to look over. And Eric is wearing some train conductor overalls. Or every color underneath the rainbow. Or stripes and dots. Some of the stuff that y'all wearing now, Eric was doing 30 years ago. And we would look over and we would say, that's our EP. We would smile, laugh, but we couldn't wait until he touched that organ or the keys. And if needed, he would even jump on the drum set. Y'all remember that? Yeah. Eric would get on that drum set. And then we would all be grooving to the sounds of the EP. Eric had the ability to make you feel as if he were his very best friend. He was attentive, loyal, loving, kind, selfless, hilarious. He was a giver. He was a protector. And he loved to eat. Has anybody ever been to dinner with Eric? Okay. He had a temper. Anybody experienced that side of Eric? He had a temper. But he was an absolute musical genius. He was a creative. And the more deeper you knew him, it all made sense as to why he was the way he was. He marched at the beat of his own drum. And whenever he felt, he would express it musically. For instance, I remember there was a concert that he asked me to attend. My schedule was full and I didn't think that I would be able to make it. However, I made it. And when I walked in, he was so excited that he started playing the theme song of the Golden Girls, Thank You for Being a Friend, in the middle of the concert. We caught each other's eyes and just started laughing because you never knew what you were going to get with EP. My father, who Eric loved, was at Cedars-Sinai Hospital preparing for his heart transplant. When Eric found out he was there, even while his mother was there receiving care, Eric was there. Eric loved with all that he had. And I'm grateful that I was a recipient of his love. As I close, I just wanted to publicly thank, I called the crew. It was VJ and it was Sam. And I privately thank you all, but I wanted to publicly thank you all for being a brother to him and to come to his rescue that nobody else knew. There's things that we know that nobody else would know. And I appreciate you all for being a brother to him. As I close, I want to thank you all for coming out to celebrate the life of this wonderful man. Thank you for this opportunity to speak on the life of Eric. Just 2 days before Eric died, he was at this very church, as Patrick has mentioned, for the musical celebration for Uncle Chuck. And he had called me and I didn't answer. And he had sent me a message on Instagram and he had sent me a message on Facebook and he finally texted me. And I want to end with his words. And he said, "Call. Music heals our souls and our hearts. We are all here because of Eric's love language. The one thing that transcended beyond religion, beyond race, beyond gender, beyond denomination. And it was the love that he had for his music." God bless you.